let us see related concepts and ideas, which is our second topic. First, we will look at OSINT, what it is. And OSINT is nothing but open source intelligence. Intelligence produced from publicly available information that is collected, exploited, and disseminated in a timely manner to an appropriate audience for the purpose of addressing a specific intelligence requirement. Further elaborating the OSINT, it is observed that security researcher Mark M. Loventhal, also an author and adjunct professor at Krieger School of Arts and Sciences at Johns Hopkins University in Washington, D.C., defines OSINT as any and all information that can be derived from overt collection. OSINT covers all type of media, government reports, other documents, scientific research and reports, commercial vendors' information, internet, and much more. More on OSINT. Open source intelligence is the collection and analysis of information that is gathered from public or open sources. It is an unclassified information that has been deliberately discovered, discriminated, distilled, disseminated to a select audience in order to address a specific question. Note, defined in NATO OSINT handbook. OSINT framework looks something similar to this. Here, first, the information that need to be gathered is mentioned, followed by the ways and the tools that are used to gather this information. Let us have a look at reconnaissance classification. It can be classified into footprinting, scanning, and enumeration. Footprinting is a technique used for gathering information about computer systems and the entities they belong to. Scanning is a deep dive into gathering more information and includes network vulnerability and port scanning. Enumeration, done via active connection and collecting information such as usernames, machines, network resources, network shares, and services on the system. Footprinting, technique used for gathering as much information as possible about computer systems and the entities they belong to. Examples are network as well as individual. It is used to understand and determine the security posture of the target. Hackers gather such information during the initial stage of attack. Scanning. Scanning falls under the category of active phase. Reconnaissance attacks begin with a scan of the network. It could be either network scanning, application scanning, or port scanning. Enumeration. An enumeration is a complete ordered listing of all the items in a collection. Enumeration is the process of extracting usernames, machine names, network resources, shares, and services from a system. Usernames using email IDs, extract information using the default password, brute force Active Directory, extract usernames using SNMP, extract user groups from Windows system, extract information using DNS zone transfer are some of the examples. Let us see how the information is collected. Information collection can be done in two different ways. One is passive method and the other one being active method. In passive method, silently collecting much more information over a period of time and takes longer time. However, such information may not be accurate. In active method, more rigorous way of information gathering, but by way of avoiding getting detected. It takes much less time and information is more accurate. let us see passive mode of reconnaissance. Here, it will not connect to the target system directly. It gathers required information without actually interacting with the target, thereby avoiding log generations. Methods could be Google searches, while driving, examining information stored on devices that are discarded. Let us have a look at the active mode of reconnaissance. Here, an intruder engages with the target system to gather information about vulnerabilities. Active reconnaissance tries to recon the target using various tools like ping, traceroute, etc. The information thus gathered is accurate and up to date, finding out information that does leave a footprint. Due to the direct interaction, it has a high risk associated of getting detected. To avoid detection, VPN, anonymous proxy, or Tor solutions is used. Let us have a look at the flow of the course. As we proceed further, it will be very confusing because there are categories and subcategories. So I thought it's a good idea to mention it here itself. Here it goes. The information collection for personal information is via passive and active mode. The organizational information collection is via passive mode. The location information collection via passive mode. The network information collection via passive and active mode. And finally, technology information collection via passive and active mode. We have not mentioned active modes for organizational and location information because they fall under the category of attack phase in the ethical hacking 5-phase model and does not fall under the category of reconnaissance. Followed by the objects for which we need to collect the information, and finally the tools that will be used for collecting information about those objects. I guess this much knowledge is sufficient. Let's proceed further.